Can you give me background on when you purchased it, where, et cetera, how that came about?
Or something? This was originally built in the winter of 59-60, opened in 1960 at Hunt's Pier. It operated at Hunt's Pier until they closed down. It became Conco's Party Pier briefly for a couple of years, and then I don't think it operated under Conco's Party Pier. Then it became Dinosaur Beach, where the ride was operated again as a slightly different ride. It had a dinosaur theme. Then that was closed down and was purchased by Maury's Piers. Maury's Piers more or less sold everything on it, except this ride. They had a number of maintenance shops and offices on it. However, it was standing but not operating. Dick Knoebel rode it. I rode it a lot in my youth. Dick Knoebel rode it in his youth. So he rode it a lot. He thought it was a great family ride. And, you know, we finally to invest. We actually investigated it a number of years ago. Being that the original structure was built out of asbestos, we really didn't want to get into asbestos abatement in the state of New Jersey. So we came across a different plan when Maury's said they were going to demolish it anyway. So we went in, we saved as much of the track as, you know, we saved the entire track and as much as everything else as we could before they knocked it down. And that was in the winter of 2009, I think. Winter of 2009.
So, and then you said it was, so originally it was themed to be a gold mine, and then it had this dinosaur theming,
yes.
And now you're changing it from a gold mine
to a coal mine.
Coal mine. Okay. And then that's more appropriate for this area then.
Absolutely. That's why we're calling it the Black Diamond.
Right.
Black Diamond is a coal.
All right. And so the whole coaster is going to be totally enclosed indoor, dark ride, theming, effects, visual, audio, the
yes.
works. Should be quite an addition. And then with the construction going along as well as it is, you hope to have it open by the...
Early part of this year.
Early part of this year. Okay. Okay, so then this section here is still to be enclosed. Is
That's
that
correct.
Going to be just that section, or is the whole building going to be from the top down, or how is that enclosure going to work?
It'll actually come from a center point up above and then radiate down outward.
Okay.
Like a half an arch.
Right. And then that leads to the lift hill to the third floor from there, on the right-hand side?
Lift hill, yes. This goes from first to second and a half.
Right, and
first
then
and
the
half.
Then the upper portion?
And then it goes up to the third floor. The upper portion is entirely on the second floor.
Yes. Okay, and so that's where the track comes out there, where that wood is right there, the second floor there?
Yes.
Okay, and then all that's still to be enclosed and all the effects added to that.
Right.
And then the building is going to extend out here, then I presume to the cement base there, the ground there?
This was added on fairly recently.
Uh-huh.
We weren't sure how to exactly do it as we were building it, and we came across this.
Right now I'm recording, right?
Yeah.
Sorry, I got about 34 seconds to record one. Now I'm just going to stop. So I stopped recording, and now what I want to do is I want to play what I recorded. You see how it's slower coming back? The timing's right, it's just they don't have enough airflow. Yeah. Not doing it the way. But it's not acting that way.
Okay, so you're saying this is staying true to the types of coal in this region?
To our Pennsylvania mining heritage.
Right.
This center of Pennsylvania here is smack dab in the middle of anthracite territory. Anthracite is a harder, cleaner, more efficient coal than your typical coal that is mined anywhere else. You blow them up one at a time, and, you know, up above there'll be one. They'll knock the supports out from time to time. It goes down, you know, the hole. Fill up the ore cars.
This is all the third floor. That's where the lift hill then comes up.
The lift hill
here.
Comes up over there. Right. There are mules in every mine, and after several generations, because they never left the mine, they were born and raised in the mine. after a couple of generations, they were being born blind because it was so dark in the mine, they couldn't see.
Oh. And so then they would lead the blind mules at that time, or
they
would have to get
rid
of
them? They would know their way around.
And what period are we talking about here?
Oh, this is from, mid-19th century to even to about 1940.
Oh. I'm not that up on the...
Well, there's still coal mines in operation around here.
The Carrick, yep.
All right.
And that's the sign you don't want.
Yeah, exactly. The canaries are bad.
So what do we have here then?
This will be a tunnel. It's actually the original tunnel mechanism from the Golden Nugget when it first opened. Uh-huh. We're doing a little bit more to it.
Uh-huh. And so this thing has been around for a while. When was this built?
The Golden Nugget was built in winter of 59, 1960.
And so all this is original then?
The barrels themselves are not original. The mechanism that turns it is original.
Okay, so it used to be that the trains would come here, and then they had
this was a turntable.
A turntable.
And they would place the cars back at that station there.
Okay, and then you are
We're going to be changing that. Currently, the plan is to put the coaster cars on another dogleg behind the ride.
Uh-huh. And what does that then allow you to do? You would be able to have then more cars on the track?
More cars, sure. Absolutely. Yeah, okay. We would certainly have more cars on the track at one time.
And then how do you control the cars then on the track if you're going to have that many?
Well, we have a number of pusher motors. The original one also used pusher motors. We're going to be spacing them slightly differently, but more or less the same throughout the entire ride. The pusher motors do two things. One, it can also push cars along if it's too slow, but also slow cars down if it's too fast. They'll also operate as a blocking system in case there's a loss of power or some other function.
Thank you very much. Okay, so you're not going to be using the old original trains? You're going to have brand new trains?
No, but we're building new trains, but they're identical in almost every way to the previous trains. I don't want to say that they are original trains, the ones that we got, because there have been some changes over the years. We don't know how old the current ones that we received with the ride are. But we're going to be using some of the same wheels, some of the same locking mechanisms, some of the same dog bones, etc., as the ones we had that arrived. So,
and are you doing the modifications to these trains, or is somebody doing that for you?
No, Knoebels is doing those.
Okay.
How you doing?